Although nymph patterns which represent mayflies are the most common, they are not the only insect to be imitated. This next pattern, a caddis pupa, is designed to simulate the many brown caddis, including the Brachia centaurus americana. It owes its origin to my friend and fly tying mentor, Paul Jorgensen. I'll begin with a scud hook, a Daiichi 1150 in size 12. The thread is brown, and I'll begin with an under wrap of thread. And this time, going well around the bend, so they get a little more curvature in the finished fly. I'm going to attach the ribbing material, which is actually will be the body material, and it's a vinyl, and it's a medium vinyl. So you see I've gone well around the back of that. Put this in the material clip for a minute because I want to dub a very tapered body on that. And the dubbing I'm going to use is brown rabbit fur. Here the taper you see is not as much as on some of the bigger nymphs we've done, but nevertheless, there is a taper. Especially you see it at the end. Beginning the wrap as close to the vinyl, or the end of the vinyl as I can. I'm going to now move forward. Let's tighten that up, continue. Until just over the top of the bend. And now I'm going to wrap the ribbing, which is actually going to be the overbody. I'm going to wrap it tight and careful, one wrap pressing against the other just slightly to give a nice segmented effect. There are so many of these different kinds, colors of caddis pupa. Everyone should have a selection of them, and they should have them in a variety of colors. Brown is very common, but bright green and olive are two other good colors to have. As you'll see, it's not a difficult fly, but extremely effective. That completes the abdomen. Basically, that completes the body. The thing that's missing now is to have some legs and to build a thorax. The legs and thorax, we can put them together into one step by using a fur dubbing, using fur as a hackle. I'm going to do that by spinning a loop. The first I do is form the spinning loop. And you see I have to close that loop. You'll notice that I'm putting that bobbin, that thread around so that there's a point there. It's got to be a closed loop pointed at the one end. I'm going to just put a little wax on that and then I'm going to hold it to the side and prepare the hair that goes in there. This is called spinning hair on a dubbing loop. I'm going to use for this process, I'm going to use the back hair of a squirrel that's been dyed brown. You also can use the back hair of a cottontail rabbit if it's small enough or if you're tying a bigger pattern. Pick out the amount of dubbing that you're going to need with the guard hairs. And I'm going to trim this very close because I want the length. And inserting my dubbing twister, I have to now position this little clump of fur up near the fly, get my fingers out of there. Going to turn this so that it gets out of the way. It's not going to interfere with the twist. Close my loop and begin to spin it. And now to wrap. Once you have your fur nicely in there, it's nice and tight, it's important that as you wrap, that all of the hair and all of the guard hairs sticking forward be placed in the back. You need to have them in the back side, so I'm going to just wet my fingers slightly, and as I wrap, you see I'm going to pull those out of the way. That's going to be important. Let's get my thread up here where it belongs, right next to the eye. Now, you see how there's guard hairs in the front? Pull them back as you wrap. Every wrap, you must keep those back. A little hard to see with my fingers in the way, but you begin to see that when I start to wrap, there's nothing sticking forward of the thread, and that's important. That way, all of the guard hairs are going back where they belong. Now you see we're forming a nice collar. Having come to the end and completing right behind the eye, I'm going to tie that off. Going to finish the head. Very small head on this one. I'm not going to use any lacquer. Because it is fur, there's no way that I can put it on there without getting into the fur and goobing it up. So let's tie it off, do our whip finish. And one step remains, and that is, we're using the fur collar to represent legs and the bulk of the thorax and the wings that hang down, but everything hangs down below this fly, and so anything on top gets trimmed off. And so now you see we've put everything, we've tucked it down underneath the fly, and that completes our caddis pupa.